Hey everyone, I'm Hayley and welcome back to What the Film School. I figured now that there are quite a few more people watching this channel than there were just a few months ago, I'd answer one of the biggest questions that I think a lot of people ask when they're looking to go to film school. And that question is, should I go to film school? Before I just simply answer this question with a yes or no, I'm gonna go back a little further to tell you why I went to film school in the first place. I had always known that I wanted to be in movies or involved with movies when I was younger. I wanted to be an actress to start, and then when I got to high school, I started playing around with more cameras and more equipment, and I thought that that was a lot more interesting to me. So throughout high school, I was just coming up with all these little story ideas and I wanted to turn them into movies, and so by the end of high school I knew that the next logical step was to just go to film school because film school was going to be the opportunity for me to learn more about the craft and hopefully become more professional with it and eventually pursue it as a career, because personally, I didn't really have any backup plans, so it was kind of film or nothing for me. And as some of you may know, I went to a state university before I transferred to NYU Tisch, and so I was trying to study film at that state school. I wasn't technically part of the program yet, but I could still take classes, and then I had to apply later on to get into it. So for me, going to a smaller film school didn't seem like a terrible option. It's obviously a lot cheaper than going to a bigger name school, but something I started to notice while I was at that school is that when I would tell people, like friends and family, like, oh, I'm here studying film, like that's my passion, people kind of didn't take it seriously. And I can understand that because obviously, you know, it's kind of difficult to compare a state university with a place like UCLA, USC, you know, all the really top film schools in the country. It was very aggravating to feel like this was something that I was really passionate about, but people kind of saw it as something that I was doing just for fun or because it was just frivolous or just something in my spare time. I noticed a big shift actually when I did get into NYU Tisch is that a lot of people started to say like, wow, you're following your dreams, you're doing your thing, you're making it happen. And I was like, yeah, but I've been doing that for the last few years. I mean, I've been following my dreams since high school. It's aggravating that there is that aspect of, you know, if you're gonna get into film school, you're competing against like the top film schools versus a place that just has a film program and doesn't really have a film school. That's one of the really aggravating things about kind of college in general, is that you're getting compared to people who are going to Ivy Leagues or, you know, the really top schools, when you're maybe going to a state school or something that is more in your league, or maybe you couldn't get into the top schools, or maybe you just don't want to go to the top schools. Is your education gonna be really better at a, you know, bigger school than it is at a littler school? What I can say from my own experience going to a state university versus going to NYU is that obviously there was a lot more funding at NYU, so that does impact the size of the program itself. So the film program obviously really fleshed out and it's got a lot of really good alumni who are able to support it. I wouldn't say at the state school I went to that I didn't learn anything, that the education was crappy, that the professors were... No, I had very good professors. I thought that the classes were really interesting. They just didn't line up with what I was intending to do, which is hands-on stuff, because it was all kind of cinema studies where I was like wanting to do film production, and those are two very different things. It's difficult for me to speak to it completely because obviously I didn't get into the film program at that state school, because like I said, you had to apply to that later on. From my experience going there, I do think it was still a good program. I do think that people shouldn't write it off immediately because, I mean, yes, it's tough when you're looking at the big name schools that have the really good alumni, but I mean, how do you think they got built up that way? It's just because more and more people went there, more and more people got interested in it, and it, you know, it got recognition because of that. So to kind of go along with the topic of this video, which is, should you go to film school? Kind of the question now is, you know, should you go to a big film school or should you go to a small one? And honestly, if you can get into the big ones, that's great, but it really all boils down to what you're looking for. Because for me, I mean, I was a very shy person, and starting out at a state university where it was a little bit smaller, there weren't like a ton of people in the community, that felt like a better start for me than just jumping into NYU immediately. But if you're really just studying film because you love it and you just want to go through school, finish your degree, and just learn more about it, then definitely going to a smaller state school or a smaller university that has a film program is a great option. You don't have to go to a place that has a strong reputation or a huge budget or, you know, a big film school. Ultimately, I don't think it really matters, because one of the big things that I want to say in this video is just that you don't really need a degree to make it in the film industry or to work in the film industry. Honestly, a lot of directors right now dropped out of film school or just didn't go to film school at all. There's definitely the option to graduate from high school, take a gap year and explore, or just decide not to go to college if it's something that you can afford to do, or just go straight into work if that's something that you'd like to do as well. Because if you're able to find a way into film production, film industry, whatever it is that you want to do without having to go get a degree for it, I think that's great. Obviously, there are a lot of good reasons to go to film school. I think that making connections there, you know, making friends and having really good relationships with professors and people that can help you out down the line is a very, very important thing. And that would be a little harder to do if you obviously weren't going to a college, you weren't seeing, you know, the same people every single day for 4 years straight. I mean, I spent a lot of time not just looking at how to be a better director in film school, but also how to produce things, how to write better, how to do all of that. And having a class structure, having weekly assignments that you have to do, having deadlines for yourself, like, that is very helpful. And also getting the feedback from people too. If you're making a short film for a class, or if you're writing a script for a class, and you go over that every week with people and you have a professor read it, then you get really helpful feedback on that kind of stuff. And while it's true that you can get friends and family to help you with that in real life, they might not have as, you know, more of a professional perspective or more of a film perspective than you'd be hoping for. Mainly is just to find the connections and make the friends and have that experience of going to college. I am still under the belief that not everybody does need to go to college, especially these days, and especially with how high the tuition is. I mean, to me, that would be the number one driver to not go to school again, is just that it's so expensive and it is very time consuming. And if it is something that you can study on your own or without having to go to a university to do it, like I said at the beginning of the video, this isn't a really good yes or no answer, because you're gonna find it all over the internet. I'm sure if you type in, you know, should I go to film school, you're gonna get yes, no, maybe no, yes, no. I mean, everyone's gonna have a different experience. And the reason that I created this channel in the hopes that obviously it's gonna grow bigger and bigger, and that there'll be more hands-on things that I can show you, more things that I can teach you, is that eventually people don't have to go to film school if they can't afford to, or if they don't want to, or if it's just not feasible for whatever reason. Because a lot of this stuff you can learn online. Part of the reason I started going to the state university first is that I got rejected from a lot of the film schools that I applied to when I was a senior in high school. And that really hurt me, because I felt like that's gonna impact my future. If I can't study film, then I can't pursue film and I can't do that and that. And that's not true at all. There's so many people on YouTube, there's so many people on the internet right now teaching extremely valuable lessons that sometimes I feel like the things that you find on YouTube you can't even find in the classroom, because oftentimes there's a lot more specific or a lot more hands-on videos or a lot more detailed videos, and you kind of get more of that one-on-one experience with a video that you might not be able to get in a classroom, or if you're going to a really big university where you're competing with all these other students around you. And I think at the end of the day, the point of you going to film school is that you just want to learn more about film, and you just want to do film, and you want to have a better outlook for your future, basically. You want to have more of an assurance that you're going to make it into the industry. So, do you need to go to film school? Well, if there was a way to find a film program that you could do where you're just studying film and you're getting the same connections and you're getting the same help that you wouldn't really find anywhere else, then yeah, it's worth going to. But then on the other hand, no, you shouldn't go if it's not feeling like the right path for you, or if it's simply just too expensive to go, or you just can't get in yourself. Then there's certainly other ways to have success, and there's certainly other ways to learn this kind of stuff, because it's not just restricted to the colleges that have a really good reputation. I hope this video makes sense. I hope that it's not too discombobulated. If you have any questions or comments about this, or you want to ask something specific about my decision to go to film school, or whether or not I think it's still a good idea, definitely leave comments below or leave questions, and I'll be happy to answer those. And don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already, like the video if you liked the video, and go check out my blog, w2filmschool.com, where I'm hoping to start posting some new blog posts every week. So definitely go check that out. And I'll see you guys again soon. Bye!